Ya, hello everyone. My name is Puput Dhani Prasetya Adi. This is my research about the SIGPI performance. The title is The Performance Evaluations of SIGPI Mass Communication on the Internet of Things. And this is a conference, AE CON CIT conference. And this is an abstract from our research. This study examines the ability and performance or quality of service of the IEEE X02.15.4 or SIGPI radio frequency module on the sensor, not SIGPI base. And SIGPI communicates capabilities, for example, tree, star, and mesh networking, were developed on the internet or Internet of Things use Raspberry Pi 4 as the internet gateway. The sensor use, for example, pulse sensor and temperature and humidity sensor. The spectrum analyzer is used to measure the radio frequency value on dBm per channels, channel 1, channel 2, channel 12 on the SIGPI module or end device and coordinators communication at different distance. On the mesh or tree SIGPI communication, SIGPI router can be used at point-to-point SIGPI. The roles of SIGPI router is neglected. Energy efficiency, battery, SIGPI sensor node need to be considered to obtain sensor node long life. RSSI is the key to analyze sensor node communication system on different sensor node clustering, including the throughput, packet loss sensor data, and data analyze on the application server. And this is a SIGPI communication IoT base, and I'm trying to communicate and analyze these communications. And this is a communication from XP, between the XP and device, router, and coordinator node, and communicate to the XP internet gateway and sending the data from the TCP IP go to the internet. And this is an example of the communications SIGPI from end device, router, and coordinator. And this is a different type examples communicate, the SIGPI communicate from the router, end device, and coordinator node. And I'm trying to use a network simulation tree to communicate SIGPI communications like this picture and this type communicate between the cluster one and cluster and another cluster and different distance. And this is a diagram, a simple diagram to know the communicate SIGPI and how to bring the data to the application server. So we use the communicate between the SIGPI or XP and the sender data XP or the connected data go to the Raspberry Pi 4, use USB cable and from the LAN go to the internet and show the application server or show the grip or from the multi-sensor. And this is a receive signal strength indicator data from end device to the coordinator around the 100 meter distance. And this is also about the throughput on the kilobyte per second data from end device to the coordinator node. Use 10 seconds about the time and the about the distance is around 100 meter distance. And the data show real time from the XGTU software, and this is around 5 kilobyte per seconds. And I try to comparison SIGPI local and remote RSSI. And this is more same. This is a same data, but still have error data on the 20 20 more than 25 yeah, between the 25 and 30 meters. This is more difference from the remote RSSI and local RSSI, and we can calculate about the error from these comparisons: local ZigBee RSSI and remote RSSI ZigBee. And average throughput on the kilobytes when the sending data from end device to the coordinator on the around 100 meters. 100 meter is on this picture. This is around 35. Yeah, this is 35, and the maximal is 100 meter. But this is, for example, 35. This is around 3.5 to 4 for kilobyte per seconds. And the data around 100 meter is different obstacle with the difference. Obstacle treatment. This is so like this. The grapes is more stable on the minus 40 dpm, and the this grape is change, yeah, change and more high on the around the minus 25 dpm. Until minus 85, and the 85 use the 85%. So we can know from this with the different obstacle treatment, we can get the rate success rate from data is around 70% to 80%. And ZigBee transmission of humidity sensor data on the more than 100 meters, this is around minus 40 dB, minus 40 dpm. And we can know the success rate is around 55 until 70%, but this is a decrease, make the decreasing from the first treatment. This is around 70%, and this is decrease go to the 55%. And this is less than or equal 100 meters. This is more high and around the 70% go to the 80%. And this is increasing. So from this experiment, we can make the conclusions. The increasing the distance transmitter ZigBee to receiver ZigBee. This is so the increasing, but this is make the decreasing on the more than 100 meter until 55%. On the less than until 100 meter, so the 70%. About the noise level or channel ZigBee radius frequency, we can know the channel 1 until channel 12. This is so about the maximum radio frequency and minimum radio frequency and the average of radio frequency value. Channel 1, for example, this is 83 dpm, and channel 12 is 77 dpm for the average radio frequency. So from this channel, we can know the strong of signals, of the power of signals on the difference distance. This is make a difference channel. And we know we can looking for this data, the channel will be decreasing with the increasing the distance. This is an example about the path loss, so we can know the calculate from the theoreticals on free space and from the experiment, so we can calculate and make the comparisons, the path loss around minus 80 dB on the with the free space with 33 log d divided by h plus 58.5, but on the free space the green free space, this is around same with the free space use the use the equation number 2, minus 20 log d plus 40.3. So I'm trying to make the comparison with the conditions of free space, but experiment is the real data from the real experiment, so we can get the data path loss. This is around 90 to 70 dB on the 5 meters, and the power receiver on the free space SIGPI, we can now from this picture is attenuations from 0 to 50 meters. This is power receiver with a power transmitter minimum, and the red line is a power receiver with maximum power transmitter. And the distance is around 50 meters. The power receiver is around minus 90 dBm. And this is an output on the application server, ThingSpeak, yeah, from the XP module communication from transmitter and receiver, and receiver go to the Raspberry Pi with the Python language and sending the data, use application programming interface and send the data and show the ThingSpeak application server. And the conclusion is, at the level transmission sensor data, use SIGPI on line of sight and free space, there are several packet loss due to a course in data transmission from TX to RX, not solely from a distance, but from the data processing. Transmission sensor data use SIGPI in free space from a sample distance of less than or equal 100 meter. It is found that RSSI has an average data transmission power of minus 97.8 dBm, seen from the remote RSSI at SIGPI end device up to distance 100 meters, and this value is entered in a good category with a score 4. In packet loss, there is a decrease in the percentage of data reception due to the transmitter error, decreasing that occurs up to 94%. This occurs at a distance of 27 meters, where the packet data loss due to the transmitter error and eliminating 13 data packet. The highest RF channel noise at channel 6 is minus 34 dBm, and the average is minus 76 dBm. Then plus channel 7 with a maximum radio frequency value is minus 35 dBm, and average is minus 77 dBm. The development of SIGPI communication system continues to be improved in terms of regulating energy or power consumption sensor node, and the communication system with the C or Python programming language and communicate with a processor or a central processing unit or mini CPU toward the server or application server. In this research, it was able to display the ST11 temperature data on the MySQL database owned by the server using Raspberry Pi 4. Furthermore, it was developed with graphical user interface or GUI, so that display of sensor data is more flexible. And thank you. This is my presentation. Good day.